بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله يقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين وَمَنْ تَطَوَّعَ خَيْرًا فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ وَأَنْ تَصُومُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ My dear brothers, as you know, we are only a few hours maybe, or maybe a few days, to enter in one of the most important months in the year, which is Ramadan. And some people, Ramadan for them is like prisoner. The court put him in a jail for 30 days. And he put 30 bars in the wall, sitting in a corner, sad in the darkness, crossing every day. Yani, as soon as sunset come, he say, one is gone, 29 left. And these kind of people, my dear brothers, they are deprived from the understanding. They don't understand what Allah wants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want our punishment. Allah says in the Quran, مَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لِتَشْقَى. Scholar, they said this ayah come when Sahaba, Allah told them to do Qiyam al-Layl with the Quran. So they stand up whole night. Ulama, they said, Rasulullah used to have swallow feet, and all Sahaba, their feet become so swallow that they cannot walk after Fajr to their home. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, مَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لِتَشْقَى. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's purpose in Ramadan is not the hunger and thirst. Because some people understanding is Ramadan to refrain from the haram. But Ramadan, my dear brothers, we have to understand. May Allah give me tawfiq and you to understand, because it is very important to understand. As I said, there is one beautiful example. One man, he used to have a garage, cars garage. He used to do mechanic, fix the cars. So all his garage is full of grease, oil, broken pieces of car. And the whole store is dark with the dirt of the cars. One day, he decided to open a garage somewhere else. And he comes to the Muslim in that area, they don't have masjid, and says, my dear brothers, I offer this garage for you as a masjid. Now, when this garage is ready to be masjid, can we write, we send someone to call Adan and we pray in that grease and dirt? What we have to do first?
Clean up.
So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order to send His rahmah to our heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants this heart to be clean. Because when you have something valuable, for example, I have pure honey. And I say, everyone who wants honey, bring me your container. So I check the container before I pour all pure honey, and I find a container full of dirt and grease. What I will tell to that guy? Please go wash your container and bring it to me, I will give you honey. If I put honey in this dirt, it will be useless. You understand, my dear brothers? So fasting, depriving ourselves from food and drink and desire, is to understand what Allah wants from me. That's why it's the month of Quran, because the word of Allah, you have to listen to it. Yani when we read the word of Allah, we listen what Allah wants. We listen to the message of Allah. So Allah, that's why Allah mentioned the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. And not only the Quran, ulama, they said all the books before. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أنزلت صحف إبراهيم في أول ليلة من رمضان. The صحف of Ibrahim, صحيفة means a big page. Sahifa in Arabic means page. That's why when they call newspaper Sahifa. So the Sahifa, it used to be a piece of leather that is big. It's called Sahifa. Suhuf Ibrahim, it means many pieces of leather where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Ibrahim his revelation. So Suhuf Ibrahim has been revealed the first night of Ramadan. Wa unzilat al-Tawrat, the Torah that has been revealed to Musa on the sixth day of Ramadan. وأنزلت الإنجيل on the 13th day of Ramadan. وأنزل القرآن on the 24th day of Ramadan. Why Allah select only Ramadan to reveal His word? يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revelation means the word of Allah, the orders of Allah, the purpose. And if there is no revelation, there is no prophet. And if there is no prophet, we will be all misguided, we will be lost. Like you drive on a road that has no sign. You don't know where you are. So the guidance comes through the messenger. And even the messenger are misguided. Misguided does not mean they commit sin, but misguided, they don't know how to please Allah. Allah said to his Rasul, وَوَجَدَكَ ضَلًّا فَهَدَى. He find you lost and he guide you. So the revelation is the way, is the right track, is the Sirat al-Mustaqim. So Allah select Ramadan only to send his word. Why? Because, my dear brothers, Allah said Quran, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Siyam has been prescribed. Whenever you hear the word in the Quran, kutiba means it's compulsory, obligatory. You cannot, it's not optional. It's compulsory. Kutiba, it means Ramadan has been obligatory, compulsory on you, as it was compulsory on the nations before you. Now, follow me. The Quran has been prescribed on us, fasting prescribed on us, as it has been prescribed on the nation before us. Revelation that come to us, which is Quran, come in Ramadan. Revelation that come to the nations before us has been revealed in Ramadan. So why Allah wants people, in order to listen to his word, to fast? Why? Because, my dear brothers, because scholar, they said the fasting is a control of the desire, is one of the most important way to stop the bad habits, to stop an addiction. Anyone who smoke, do any bad habits, if he does not refrain, if he does not use Ramadan as a tool to refrain, there is no way that he can do it in the 11th month. Now, even you did not do it in the Ramadan when you are busy, fasting during the day, making qiyam during the night, waking up, so you are extremely busy. If you cannot do that now, when you can do that? When? And not only that, Allah help you by chaining the shayateen. Yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan, he chained the shayateen. And some scholars, they are saying, they said, Allah chained the shayateen even in Ramadan previously. Because Ramadan is not for this ummah. Ramadan has been the month that Allah select out of the month of the year to, so people can fast. And the proof that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Torah has been revealed 6 day of Ramadan. You understand? So let's come back to our topic. Allah wants us to listen to his word when we are fasting. The combination between the Quran and the fasting is, the purpose is to achieve the taqwa. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. And the taqwa, my dear brothers, it means to practice the Quran. The man who practices the Quran simply is among the muttaqin. Because what does it mean, taqwa? Taqwa means to avoid. Ittaqi, avoid. Don't touch this. Taqi. So taqwa means you don't do the haram at all. And you are busy with the good deeds. It means you practice the Quran. So in order to achieve the taqwa, which is the practice of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create for you an environment, which is called Ramadan. So he chained the shayateen. He chained the shayateen. He asked you to fast during the day. And he make you busy in qiyam during the night. And he asks you now to focus, to practice, to achieve this quality in order that your heart become purified. So you can receive. You know this electronic? There is a receiver. And there is what? A channel that send the waves, you know? So if you have good receiver, the view is crystal. But if you have an old transistor of the 70s, then the wave is shaky. It's only, you see only, huh? So some people, they understand. They listen what Allah wants. They understand what does it mean Ramadan. So they enjoy it. And the purpose why some people, they enjoy it, ulama, they said, Rasulullah, it has been reported in Imam Nawawi, that the Salaf, they ask Allah 6 months. Imagine, people sometimes, the night of Ramadan, they are sad. They don't like that 30 days of fast. SubhanAllah, may Allah give us hidayah. 6 months, the Salihin ask Allah to give them life to reach this Ramadan. كَانَ السَّلَفْ يَسْأَلُونَ اللَّهَ سِتَّةَ أَشْهُرُ. 6 months to reach Ramadan. and they consider only that Allah give you life, till you meet Ramadan, it's by itself ni'mah from Allah to you. It's rahmah from Allah to you. Why? Because the Salaf wish to die after three actions. When they go in path of Allah, they wish to die. When they perform Hajj, they wish to die. And when they finish Ramadan, they wish to die. Why? Because Ramadan is a month of forgiveness. Allah grant forgiveness. Allah find any ways to forgive us. Can you imagine? Look the rahmah of Allah. Allah find any small mean to grant us forgiveness. Rasulullah said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi." Whosoever fast Ramadan with iman, iman, this is the order of Allah. I'm not fasting because my parents fast, because my country fast, because my country is Muslim country. No, because Allah ordered me. I am slave of Allah, and Allah ordered me, so I'm obeying the order of Allah. This is called iman. Ihtisab, whatever hardship I face, whatever struggle I face, whatever hunger and thirst I face, it's a communication of the heart. Oh Allah, reward me for this. I seek your pleasure. In your heart, you don't talk. You don't say, this Ramadan is too long, brother. It's too hot. I don't know how can I do that. You understand? This is complaining. When you complain, you lose the reward. Or when you face people with anger, or you become mean. Especially people who have bad habits, yani you don't touch them between Asr and Maghrib. They become like a wild tiger. You just tell him, how are you? He jump on you. They call them in our country, Mramdan. Mramdan means Ramadan affect them. So these kind of people, even in our country, they know them by their names. Especially people who have bad habits. So nobody even tell them, Salaam alaikum. Can you imagine? Salaam alaikum is hard. But you don't tell him that. Because if you tell him Salaam alaikum, he's jumping you. So they just avoid them. Why, my dear brothers? Because we don't understand that Ramadan, my dear brother, is a school. Ramadan is a rahmah. Look, ulama, they said the whole system changed. The universe changed. By the first night of Ramadan, Rasulullah said, إِذَا كَانَ أَوَّلُ لَيْلَةٍ مِنْ Ramadan. On the first night of Ramadan, it means right after sunset when they announce Ramadan. You did not even fast. Because in Islamic calendar, the night comes before the day. So Rasulullah said, إِذَا كَانَتْ أَوَّلُ لَيْلَةٍ مِنْ Ramadan, فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجِنَانِ فَلَمْ يُغْلَقْ مِنْهَا بَابٍ. Gate of Jannah opens, none of them closed. Now the gate of Jannah, between bracket, Rasulullah say, between the two sides of the gate of Jannah, like between Mecca and Hajar. Or, and he said the hadith, or between Mecca and Busra. Now, it's amazing. Say Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. Who give to Rasulullah the GPS or the geometric, or give him the calculation? The distance between Mecca and Busra in Bahrain, 1,272 kilometers. The distance between Mecca and Hajar in Bahrain, 1,272, and the distance between Mecca and Busra, 1,272 kilometers. Rasulullah said in hadith, between each gate of Jannah is like the distance between Mecca and Busra and Hajar, or between Mecca and Hajar and Busra. And they find out it's the same distance, 1,272 kilometers. Allahu Akbar. Allah. This is the revelation. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. So the gate of Jannah opens. None of the gate of Jannah closed. Look, this happening now, this night. Yani Jannah are closed. But in Ramadan, the gates are open 30 days till they announce the day of Eid. فَلَا يُقْفَلُ مِنْ هَبَىٰ وَتُغَلَّقُ أَبْوَابَ الْجَهَنَّمِ. The gate of Jahannam, may Allah save us, closed. And none of the gate of Jahannam opens. وَتُصَفَّدُ فِيهِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. And the shayateen are chained. The angel chained the shayateen, send them to the islands or to deserted place so they cannot spoil our fasting. Yani look how much Allah is making the, like the Urdu people, they said, mahol. Allah make the environment for us to do the ibadah. And the angel announced, يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ. بَاغِيَ, in Arabic, in our slang, Moroccan, they said, أنا تنبغيك. It means I love you. Baghi, it means you love to do good deeds. You just don't do it because of bad habits or because you compete with someone. No, you love to do good deeds in this month. Ya baghi al khayri aqbil. Come, this is your time. This is the bargain. This is the month of the crop. This is time when you cannot hesitate or delay. Just do any good deeds. وَيَا بَغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَقْسِرْ. And whosoever is busy in the bad deeds, he should stop. So my dear brothers, scholars, they said, Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant forgiveness in this month. يَقُولُ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الصلاة الخمس والجمعة إلى الجمعة ورمضان إلى رمضان مكفرات ما بينهن ما لم تخشى الكبائر. He says the five daily salat and from the جمعة to other جمعة and رمضان to رمضان Allah wipe out the sin except the major sin. Major sin we have to be to do tawbah. So one of the first gift in this Ramadan that all the minor sin that we commit from the last Ramadan till this Ramadan Allah wipe it out. Number two, my dear brothers, Rasulullah says, whosoever fasts one day, not Ramadan, one day it means in the 11th other month, one day, tatawwu, he has no debt, he doesn't have to pay any, he was sick in Ramadan, he has to pay it, he just wants to fast one day, like Ashura, or days of Dhul Hijjah, or Monday and Thursday, whatever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah said, ba'ad Allahu jasadahu an nar masirata sab'ina sana. Allah make his body far from Jahannam by a distance of 70 years walking distance. And in another hadith, whosoever fasts one day for the sake of Allah, Allah make trench between him and Jahannam like the distance between earth and sky. This is ulama, they said, called tatawwu, the nafil. Now the farida, as all of us has to know, the farida is way more important in the eyes of Allah and rewarded in the eyes of Allah than the nafil. For example, the five daily salat are better than 50 nafil salat. Five daily salat that you pray, better than you do 10 times the nafil salat. The zakat compulsory on you to pay is better than your charities that you give throughout the year. And the fasting of Ramadan better than the whole year of fasting. Why? Because Rasulullah say, if someone eats one day without excuse, say for example someone, shaitan puts in his mind or he becomes so yani weak that he eats one day without excuse. يقول رسول الله من أفطر يوما من رمضان لم يقضيه صيام الدهر. Even if he fasts the whole day, the whole year, 360 days, he cannot pay that day. It means if he die as committing a major sin. So the fasting, my dear brother, of the compulsory is way better than the nafil. So Allah loved the fard first. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers, in this month, bless us with forgiveness of sin. So if you fasting only compulsory, nafil fasting, Allah make your body far from Jahannam 70 years, how much Allah will do for you if you fast the compulsory month. Rasulullah, my dear brothers, say that in this month, Rasulullah say, Allah give to my ummah five things. He did not give it to the nation before. أعطى الله لأمتي خمس خصال من الخير لم تؤتهن أمة قبلها. No nation before has been given this blessing. Five gifts Allah give to this ummah. First thing, خلوف فمي الصائم أطيب عند الله من ريح المسك. The خلوف, خلوف, my dear brother, is not the smell of the food by the negligence of brushing your teeth in the suhoor. Because some people they misunderstood and they don't clean their teeth and they said the smell of the mouth is pure in the eyes of Allah than the smell of musk. No, that is wrong. You must brush your teeth. And Imam Shafi says, even you can use the miswak in the morning before duhur. And why he said before duhur? Because after the stomach become empty, it releases some chemical that help digest the food inside the stomach. That chemicals has a reaction because it's empty and keep releasing it to make noise. It releases some smell through the mouth because of hunger. So that smell, it's a smell of effort, mujahada. Stomach is angry and you feel the pain of hunger. Allah loved that reaction of that empty stomach, and he loved that smell more than the smell of musk. خَلُوفُ فَمِ السَّعِيمِ. Or else you have to be very mindful about your cleanness. Cleanness of the mouth, using the miswak before the salat. Number two, Rasulullah said, يُزَيِّنُ اللَّهُ فِيهَا جَنَّتَهُ. Allah decorates Jannah. And as you know, my dear brother, Jannah is decorated every day. Everyone from the Muslim, when he says Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allah plants tree in Jannah. So imagine how many tasbih the Muslim are doing in the whole world every day. This is the number that Allah plants of trees in Jannah. So decoration is done every day. But in Jannah especially, Allah has special decoration. Decoration is way better than all the 11 months. And Allah say, Yushiku, Yushiku. It means very soon, my beloved slave will be shifting from this dunya to you, so they can relax. Yani, not only Allah is decorating, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He miss us. Because Jannah, we will be the neighbors of Allah. So Allah decorate Jannah and talk to the Jannah. He says, it's daddy, become more beautiful, more bright, more shining for my slave, because soon they will come to you and they will relax. Number three, my dear brothers, Allah closed the gate of Jahannam and closed the gate of Jannah. Scholar, they said, what does this mean? Because some people, they said, if you die in Ramadan, you go directly to Jannah, and if a sinner die in Ramadan, he will not go to hell. No. This means, my dear brothers, that the asbab of Jannah are wide open. And the asbab of Jahannam are completely difficult. And subhanAllah, believe me, my dear brothers, even the people who commit sin and drink wine. I remember in our country, the man who has a bar, Muslim, out of respect of this man, there is no government, will not punish him. He closed down his store. And he starts coming to the masjid with qamis and pray salat and fast the day. I know this is doing wrong because his money is haram. But people have respect of this month. Yani the hurma of this month is so big. Yani the sin, ulama, they said, like Mecca. Mecca, when Allah honor a place or honor a month, it has a hurma. Hurma means respect. So if you do sin in that, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose as a land or place, it's not like sin in a normal place or normal time. For example, sin in Mecca. If someone commits sin in Mecca, it's not like committing sin in other place. If you commit sin in Ramadan, it's not like the committing sin in other place. Why? Because there is no chance to commit sin. When you commit sin, it means it is your nafs. It is the reaction of your nafs. Your nafs is your worst enemy. It's only the reflect of the bad habits. Number five, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them forgiveness. So one Sahabi says, O Prophet Allah, is it the night of destiny? Rasulullah said, no, the man who do the work get his salary at the end of the job. Now this is another forgiveness. Look, my dear brother, how much Allah's mercy in this month. This is another forgiveness. This is the forgiveness on the night of Eid. Rasulullah say, every night Allah saved thousands from Jahannam. وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَى مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلًا. In the night of the Eid, He grant salvation from Jahannam. The number that He saved every night multiply 30 or 29. The night of Eid. This is one forgiveness. Second forgiveness, Laylatul Qadr. مَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ دَنْبِهِ. Third forgiveness, قيام الليل من قام رمضان. قام means because we have, you see, my dear brother, all the time extreme understanding create division. Remember this formula: extreme create division, break the ummah. You have to be humble. You cannot think that you do something, you are special. No, that's wrong. Yusuf, when he make dua to Allah, what he says, توفني مسلما والحقني بالصالحين. Look how humble. He is Nabiullah. He said, make me die as a Muslim. Al-Hiqni. And join me among the pious. And he is Nabiullah. Sulaiman, he says, Adkhilni bi rahmatik fi ibadik al-salihin. Enter me with your mercy among your pious slave. Those are anbiya, but they are humble. They are down. So when people, for example, interruh pray 23 rak'ah, and someone pray only 2 rak'ah, both of them did qiyam. Qiyam is to means the to do the minimum. Of course, we don't say ask people to do 2 rak'ahs, but if someone is tired or busy, or he come only to pray Isha and he do 2 rak'ahs, 4 rak'ahs, 6 rak'ahs, that is not wrong. Because there is no formula of 20 rak'ahs, my dear brother, by the way. It is the sunnah of Umar. Rasulullah, when the Qiyam al-Layl has been, he wants to mention to his ummah to do it in the night of Ramadan. He come on the first night of Ramadan, second night of Ramadan, and third night of Ramadan, he enter his home. So he read the Salat of Tarawih with small group. Other people will pray in Sunnah or reading Quran in the side. Small group come to him. The third night he come home. So when he come home, the people who pray with him behind him on the two nights of Ramadan join him in his home, pray with him, the masjid, the house become packed. Then Rasulullah come back to the masjid and says, oh people, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, oh people, what stopped me from not coming here and lead the salat for you of the Taraweeh is that I am afraid that if I lead you every night, Jibreel will come down and make it compulsory. Khiftu an tufrada alaykum. Look the mercy of Rasulullah to his ummah. If Taraweeh become compulsory, what will be our situation? You don't do it, you are out of Islam because it's compulsory. So the Rasulullah, he mentioned indirectly to do it. But he did not do it because Jibreel is coming, Tashri'a, Quran is not complete yet. He was afraid that become compulsory. Abu Bakr Siddiq, he was busy, he did not did. He keep it as it is. Scattered groups doing Taraweeh al-Day. Umar ibn Khattab, he sat one day in Ramadan and says, Arab, I think if I gather all these groups under one imam, it will be better. So he called Ubay ibn Ka'b and another Sahabi and asked them to lead the Taraweeh and finish the Quran. In Medina, in the time of Tabi'in, just to understand, they used to pray 36 rak'ah. So there is no formula of 23 or 8. They used to pray. He says we used to pray 36 rak'ah and we used to lean towards the wall and the sticks by standing too much. And we used to rush the slave servant to bring the food before the Adhan al-Fajr. They pray all night, every night, the whole night in Qiyam. So that's why, my dear brother, Qiyam al-Layl means he pray few rak'ahs after Aisha. That's called Qiyam al-Layl. Rasulullah say, Man qama Ramadan. He did not specify the number because Rasulullah was merciful. But if some group pray 8, pray 14, pray 20, Alhamdulillah, they did Qiyam al-Layl. But more important than that, as Umar ibn Khattab say, is the tahajjud before the suhur. Qala Umar, wallati tanamuna anha, khayr min al-tiquma. Last thing, inshallah, before I finish, my dear brother, in this month, month of charity and infaq, because Rasulullah say, the best charity is the charity in this month of Ramadan. And the best dua is the dua of Ramadan. The best Umrah is the Umrah of Ramadan. The best Quran is the Quran of Ramadan. The best, any good deeds you do. Khisal al-Khair means the good deeds. Any good deeds you do, it's like compulsory in the reward. Any compulsory amal you do, it's like 70 reward of 70 compulsory amal. So that's why, my dear brother, this month is not the month to be stingy. Why? Because Allah is so generous in Jannah. So generous in this month. Just spend. And I don't mean, my dear brother, whenever I talk as an imam and I say generous charity, some people they think about Masjid Project donation box. No. I mean, when I say generosity, send money to your family, to your sister, to your brother. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أفضل الصدقة صدقة الرحم الكاشح. Kashih means he's doing like this. He hates you. Why he hates you? You are his own relatives, but you don't send him any money, and he's very poor. So even if you come to country and visit him, he's all the time angry, he doesn't invite you, he doesn't talk to you. Rasulullah say, the best charity is the charity of that relatives. Why? Because you clean your heart by helping him. So this is the month, my dear brothers. Some people, they don't have even food or dates to break their fast. So let's be generous, let's spend, and Allah will spend on us. Assalamu alaikum.